Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Exotic Astrology, and we are witnessing a very special astrological event today. I shall describe what that is, and most of you would be aware of what's happening today. There are many planets who are in own sign or exaltation, and many of you have asked me a very crucial question: that is there something amazing or life-threatening which will happen today? Well, you have to always understand the most important principle of Vedic astrology is DASHAS. Have you heard of the word? That is what distinguishes you. That is what sets you apart from the rest of the people. Rest of the billions of people that you see. Yes, that's how you know what's happening in your life. So therefore, the million-dollar answer is whatever is in your dashas, that will happen. It will not only happen today, it will happen tomorrow, it will happen the day after, for the next 100 years. Or maybe 1,000 years, if you live like people lived in Dwapar Yuga, you will still be getting results depending on your dashas. Dashas are the most important feature in Vedic astrology. So most of the times the problem is you guys see videos in YouTube where nobody talks about dashas. They only talk about transits. And that is where you go wrong. Okay. So therefore, instead of asking questions like what will happen on this day, which many people are doing, and many others are making videos, and there are like hundreds and thousands of views. So instead of asking these questions, we should ask, how should we utilize this day? Because this is a very special day, because today is also Ekadashi. Ekadashi is the 11th lunar day, 11th Tithi, which is very important if you want to do some spiritual progress. So some spiritual practices, and you want to make a rapid spiritual progress. They say whatever is done during an Ekadashi, any spiritual practice is multiplied by 1,000 or maybe million times, depending on your awareness and your consciousness. Okay, so therefore, I don't know what time is it in India. It's 12:30 here, so maybe it's already 4 p.m. in India, but you still have almost like half of the day, or at least 6-7 hours. So please utilize this day to do more spiritual practices. Okay, so let's discuss a bit on what's actually happening. So if you, if I go to dritpanchang.com, Sun is in Uttar Falguni Nakshatra, is in Leo, his own sign, and Moon has entered Cancer, Punarvasu Nakshatra, fourth Charan, just entered Cancer, I would say. And Mangal, Mars, is in Aries. He's retrograde. He's about to go retrograde. He's already retrograde. He's about to enter Pisces after some days. Then Mercury is in Virgo. He has crossed the degree of exaltation, and now he's in Mool Trikon. He's in 17 degrees of Virgo. And Jupiter is in Mool Trikon again, Sagittarius. Although not in degree-wise Mool Trikon, but the sign is still Sagittarius. Venus is the only planet which is not there in either exaltation or Mool Trikon, okay, or own sign. He's in Cancer. And Saturn, as usual, is retrograde till the end of this month, and he's in the sign of Capricorn. And Rahu and Ketu are in their signs of exaltation. So how many exalted planets are there? If you consider Mercury to be exalted in Virgo, irrespective of the degrees. So it's three planets, Saturn, Rahu, and Ketu. Mercury, Rahu, Ketu. And then you consider Moon, you can take it if you are taking for the current time, because now Moon has entered 2 degrees. So you can take Sun, then you can take Moon, then you can take Saturn. These three are in own sign. And Mars and Jupiter, you could say they are in Mool Trikon. Okay. So essentially, except Venus, all the planets are in very good dignity today. And Mars is in the degrees of Mool Trikon. So he is officially in Mool Trikon. Okay. Okay. Therefore, now Venus is in Cancer, but the Lord of Cancer, who is Moon, who is also sitting there. Okay, Venus is in Pushya Nakshatra and Moon is in Punarvasu. He is about to enter Pushya after some time. Very soon, I guess. 2 more degrees. 1 degree, in fact. And therefore, today, see, you have to understand what happens when these planets are in such dignified positions. The awareness is very high. The awareness, it's very easy to connect to something higher in life. Okay, so this day, for most, for 99.9% of the people, although so many people have created unnecessary, useless hype for this day, you would have seen this day was maybe just like any other day. Imagine you did not know astrology and tomorrow somebody told you, you know, oh, you know, there were these big, big things happening, you know. And you'd be like, oh, okay, what happened in my life? Yeah. So therefore, this happens because we prioritize transits more than nashas, okay. And why do people do that? Because it's very easy to read transits because it's cheap. Okay. So in Kali Yuga, my Shiksha Guru used to say, Kali Yuga is a place of cheaters and the cheated. So people cheat you by telling that transits are very important. And then you also get cheated by listening to all these people, right, who say that transits are all in all. No, it's very easy to see a transit, but it is very difficult to analyze a dasha. Mm-hmm. Because to analyze a dasha, you need lots and lots of deep astrological research. Because people always ask me, oh, my Jupiter will transit 10th house next year. What will happen? Well, whatever is in your dashas will happen. It doesn't matter where your Jupiter, Saturn, Mars is transiting. All right. Once you check the horoscope, then you check the dashas, then you check the transit. So now the thing is, irrespective of your dashas, if you only talk of transits, then this day is a very good day in consideration to awareness. Okay. Now, this does not mean that there cannot be a major calamity today, or everybody will feel very nice and very loved, and you know, everybody will become like people in Satya Yoga. So it might happen that after 1 hour of me making this video, there is a bomb blast somewhere and there are 1,000 people dead. It could happen. It could happen there is a tsunami in the night. It could happen there are, you know, people dying due to some other reasons. Anything can happen. So the only problem with these fancy transits is that we end up expecting that something either very good is going to happen or something very bad is going to happen. You know, either everybody is going to die, the world will end, or my life will change. All my problems will just disappear. All right. So let's not waste time talking about all this. The only thing which we can discuss today is what should you do. So for example, assuming that you are running standard dashas, not very extreme dashas, you know, something very extreme is not happening to you. Your life is relatively normal. Like, you know, for example, you are not undergoing some serious life-threatening calamity or something. Assuming you are sitting in home, or you at least have a roof and you are watching this video, assuming. So Sun is in Uttar Falguni Nakshatra. Okay. So Uttar Falguni is the nakshatra which is very much related to Yamaraj also. Now you may say, oh, but Bharani is related to Yamaraj. How is Uttar Falguni related to Yamaraj? Yes, Uttar Falguni is related because Aryaman is related to Uttar Falguni. And when Yamaraj was cursed by a rishi to come down to this earthly plane, and in the body of a human being. So then what happened? Aryaman was the one who was ruling Pitraloka that time. Okay. So therefore, if you want to do any worship related to either Yamaraj or Aryaman, it's a very good day. Or Aryaman, Uttar Falguni also has to do with contracts, deals, negotiations and all. So if there's anything which you plan to do with somebody, you want to kick off a project, then it's a very good day today. Okay. This is something which you can do. Then Moon is in Punarvasu. Punarvasu Nakshatra. Very crucial for completing unfinished projects. So for God's sake, if you had left something which you did not complete, then please do it. Finish it today. Yeah. And Uttar Falguni Nakshatra is being blessed by the Sun. So therefore, you can actually help, you can take the help of your friends or your colleagues or anybody or your family members also in getting the old things done because of moon's presence in Punarvasu. Okay. So Punarvasu and Uttar Falguni can work in a very harmonious way. So these are things which you can do. You can utilize this day like this. And then later through the day, moon will enter Pushya Nakshatra. So during that time, later phase of the day, you can spend your time doing some meditation or connecting to your gurus. This is how you can use. Then Mars is in Ashwini Nakshatra. And Ashwini Nakshatra is a very beautiful nakshatra, which shows that you are trying to do something revolutionary. So depending on the houses which Mars rules in your chart, if you feel that you need to do something revolutionary, you can do that. Ashwini is meant for creation. Okay, so therefore, you have Sun in Uttar Falguni and you have Moon in Punarvasu and then you have Mars in Ashwini. So it can work either ways. You start something new, which is revolutionary, or to complete something which you did not do earlier, you do something revolutionary. Okay, you apply certain techniques which you know deep down. Actually, Ashwini is very beautiful because Ashwini is that feeling inside of you which tells that maybe you need to do something different. But then there's that person inside you which always tells, no, be as you are. So Ashwini shows breaking the comfort zone and stepping out. If you know the story of Ashwini Nakshatra, the story is related to Ashwini. So, but this will primarily be related to the houses which Mars rules in the chart. Then Mercury is in 17 degrees of Virgo, Hasta Nakshatra. This is a very important nakshatra. This is the nakshatra of the moon. And Mercury and moon are sometimes not getting well very much. But you can use this nakshatra very beautifully. So Hasta Nakshatra has a lot of things to be done in the background actually. Hasta Nakshatra always shows things which it's not in the limelight. You know, Hasta things are always in the back foot, as they say. It's not front foot, it's back foot. So in your life, there are certain areas which you will feel. Whenever any planet transits Hasta, you will feel that there is a lot of groundwork to be done, which I have not done actually. Because of that, what is happening, I am not seeing the results in the external front. So it can be anything. You might be trying to learn astrology, but then maybe you are just watching transit videos. So you have not done the groundwork of putting in the time and energy and effort that you need to learn astrology. Like sometimes many people ask me, oh, I want to learn astrology from Exotic Astrology YouTube channel. And then I tell them, go to my Astrology Basics playlist, OMG Astrology Secrets playlist. And then they lose their minds. They tell me, oh, what? 500 videos are there. Your videos are 25 minutes long. Should I invest 600 videos? Time of 20-25 minutes, and I'm like, all right, you must do that. Even anywhere else you go, you will need at least 3 to 5 years to learn astrology. You cannot learn astrology in 3 months. It's not possible. You cannot learn engineering in 1 month. You need 4 years and 18 years prior to that from your nursery, okay? KG nursery, UKG, whatever. So how do you expect that you learn astrology in 3 months? It's just not possible. They're just cheating you and you are happily, royally getting cheated. All right. So don't get cheated like this from people who tell you that we will teach you astrology in 3 months. You can learn predictive astrology. Predictive astrology, anybody can learn in 2 months, maybe 1 month, 3 months, 6 months. But you won't ever become an astrologer in 3 months. Knowing to predict something and becoming an astrologer, there's a big difference actually. It's like huge difference. And knowing how to help people, that is at another level. That will take you years actually. Okay. Now, I'm not saying that I have reached that level, but what I'm telling is I'm sharing from my experience. You cannot learn all this. So use the power of this Hasta Nakshatra, which Mercury is transiting in. Okay. And then Jupiter is in Purva Shada and... since I made that video for Jupiter being direct, many of you have sent me mails that, yes, you have kicked off new projects pertaining to the houses which Jupiter rules in the chart. And there's a sense of hope and there's a sense of optimism and there's a sense of belief that you will make it. So keep through it, keep making through it, and you will definitely succeed. And Venus is in Pushya Nakshatra. So the houses which Venus rules in your horoscope, those houses, you might feel the need to take guidance from your gurus. Whenever a planet transits Pushya, this happens. You always feel a need to take guidance from somebody. That is why Mars gets debilitated here, because Mars, he feels that I should do it myself. Why should I ask everybody else? Okay. Mars is that arrogant, independent fool inside us who tells you don't need anybody. Okay. And then Shani Maharaj is in Uttarashada. Uttarashada is the nakshatra which is very crucial if you want to finalize something. So this energy is very harmonious in a way that you are starting new things, you are ending old things, and you are finalizing things. All right. So you can use this very beautifully if you wish to. Then Rahu Maharaj is in Mrikshira and Ketu is in Gandanta as usual. Ketu in Gandanta. Mm-hmm. Very good time for spiritual progress, as I said in my Ketu video. Shedding your old skin and getting a new one, which means acknowledging your weaknesses and your anarthas and then trying to work on it. And the last, of course, is Rahu in Mrikshira. This is very interesting because now gradually people are starting to meet more and more online. And this I had said in my Rahu transit to Mrikshira video long back when I made that now you will see people are, you know, getting into making things online. And many people have messaged me that since Rahu have entered Mrikshira, they had certain interests of cooking, which they have started, how do I say this? They already had it. They were already doing it, but now they have opened some Instagram page or some YouTube channel and they have started sharing all this, all right? Mrikshira related to food and all this. So if you are interested, then you can also do that. Okay, there are many people I know who are doing all this in Instagram. They are sending parcels. They make, you know, like cakes or cookies or whatever, even in Indian desserts. And then, like, I know people who send kaju barfis. Yeah, it's like they are sitting in home and they are making themselves and they are sending. All right. So these things have happened when Rahu has entered Mrikshira. And Rahu in Mrikshira can give you too much temptation sometimes to eat the things which you should not eat. All right. So therefore, eat the right stuff. You know, eat healthy. It's not that you have to starve yourself and eat nothing. Eat the right foods, and you will be very happy. All right. So therefore, today is also Ekadashi. Ekadashi is specially blessed by Lord Vishnu, and you can also chant Vishnu mantras. Today you can chant Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. You can also chant the mantra for Vamandev especially. Om Namo Bhagavate Shri Vamana. It's very good to chant these two today. Okay? And if you are chanting any other Vishnu mantras, then you can do more of these rounds. All right. So that is how you can utilize today and the next few days also, because this will continue for some time, because only Moon will go out of Cancer. All the planets are still the same. Okay. For maybe in the next 10 days at least. Okay, so for the next 10 days, this will continue. Okay, so utilize this transit period, but don't overhype it and don't think that, you know, the world is going to change or something like that. That could happen, but that will happen because of your individual dashas. Okay, and whatever happens, even if there's a bomb blast today, or there's a terrorist attack, or, you know, there's a tsunami, or suddenly some good news comes in, you have to understand that everybody, each and every one of you, will be affected depending on your dashas. Okay, so do not forget the deshkal patra. Okay, and do not superimpose these fake superficial transit stuff on your dashas. Never do that. That's criminal. Okay, do not do it for yourself. Don't do it for others also. Otherwise, people will lose faith in the science of Jyotish. People, that's why people say astrology doesn't work. And I ask them why. Oh, you know, actually what happened, Mr. Venus transited in my 7th house and I didn't get married. And I said, all right, who said that Venus transit in your 7th house can give you marriage? Well, if marriage is denied in your horoscope, you may never get married. Doesn't matter where, which planet transits. All right. So therefore, this is just an example. It's a very extreme example, I know, but that's how people behave these days. Okay. So analyze your horoscope, analyze your dashas, then you go to transits. But irrespective of that, you can utilize the next 10 days very beautifully. All right. Thank you very much for your patience. And if you're new to the channel, then please subscribe to it below. And if you want a consultation from me regarding your transits, no, your dashas or your practical life, any area of your life, then you can always go to my website down below in the description section. And yes, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and he will help you irrespective of where the transits are happening. Okay. Thank you very much.